Hi guys, welcome back to another Mindful Motherhood video. Today I want to talk about relieving the pressure of homeschooling. I know some of us are feeling incredibly overwhelmed with the homeschooling expectations, either from the school that your children go to, family, friends, what other people are doing on Instagram, and it's a really difficult time to be adding on pressure. And recently I posted a video on our schedule for homeschooling, and I didn't want anyone to think that we're kind of this military family that follow us in a specific schedule every day. So I wanted to do this video to kind of show there is a human behind that schedule, and I also feel pressure like everyone else. For our family, schedules and routines seem to work better than just winging it, but that's just what happens in our family. But despite all that, I wanted to touch upon things that are helping me relieve that pressure of homeschooling when I'm feeling like I don't want to do it, or I feel like I'm failing or not doing it as well as I should be. There are a few things that I try and keep in mind, so I wanted to share these with you in case these are helpful to you. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it and share it with your friends, and leave your comments below with your own tips of how you're relieving the pressure of homeschooling. And now let's get straight into the video. So first of all, I like to remind myself that this is the most unusual of circumstances, that we've never been through anything like that in our lives, and the schools have never been through anything like that as well. So we're all in uncharted territory, we're all doing the best we can. And if I find, or if you find, that your child's school is putting too much pressure on homeschooling, tell them. Likelihood is that they're gonna listen to your feedback and reassure you that what you're doing is enough. And I feel like most schools are being understanding at this difficult time, and knowing that parents are having to do jobs that they've never had to do at the same time before, like their own work from home, parent one or more children, look after the house, look after everyone's well-being all at the same time. And usually we compartmentalize those things in our lives, and we have time for everything. So schools will be understanding, and I keep reminding myself, this is a very unusual situation. This is not the norm, and there is a reason why we are feeling overwhelmed. The second thing I like to remind myself of is that it's not my job to replace my child's teacher. My obligation remains the same, and that is to be my child's mother. I'm not a teacher, and that's okay. But even if you are a teacher and a parent, you're not your child's teacher. Don't put that pressure on yourself to think because you're a teacher, then you have to know how to navigate the situation, because you don't have to. We're doing the best we can with the limited resources we have, and that's okay. The third thing I like to do is give myself a break and remember that schools will cover everything. There is no new learning that we're supposed to be teaching our children during this period for the first time ever. And when schools resume, when kids are back in school, everything will get back to normal. The first thing they'll probably do is run over everything that happened over the last term or the term that they lost, and catch everyone up and get everybody up to speed. So there is no pressure in the sense of feeling that you're introducing something new, and if you don't teach this to your child, they're going to be falling behind in school. That is not going to happen. And that's a really good reminder to myself, because sometimes when I see homework coming in, I feel like the pressure is on me to be able to teach properly. But I trust that the schools will cover everything once we're back to normal. And of course, any work that you do with your child during this time is positive and it will help them, but it's not nothing to worry about, agonize over. Next, I'm telling myself that it's okay to find things to occupy them so I can get some work done, because my job hasn't stopped and I'm still working from home. I've still got demands and responsibilities and times and things that I have to get done. It just happens that now I've got to do that all around the children's time. So I tell myself it's okay to give them the iPad so I can get some work done. It's okay to put a movie on for them to watch so I can do stuff and get stuff done, and not feel guilty about that. And there are so many iPad, iPhone, tablet apps that are educational and entertaining for kids, and these ones are the ones that I feel less guilty about. I'm gonna share a list of my favorite educational apps for this period of lockdown. I've done a similar video already on my favorite educational apps, but I have a brand new list with lots of new apps that I love giving to my children when I need to get some work done. I don't want to feel guilty that they are on the iPad. I don't want to just give them YouTube and let them browse YouTube like for hours. So yeah, I'm gonna share that soon. My next little pep talk is to make sure that this time we spent together is positive, enriching, and things that my children couldn't be doing if they were in school. And that's a really good way to stop worrying about what your children are missing out in school. I find myself doing that all the time, getting really worked up and emotional about how much they're missing out and what this is happening at a time of their lives where they should be learning, they should be in school, they should be interacting with their friends, and they're missing all of that. So instead of holding on to that negative feeling, I try to turn it around into a positive and think that this time, this experience, and these things that I can do with them are things that they could only do right now with me. Doing little projects around the house, baking together, going out for walks, making memories, and remembering this time as a time when we were all together and having fun. And I hope that that's what my children remember. And finally, I like to remind myself that everyone is on the same boat. No one has a different situation where they're not having these thoughts, these worries, and we're all going through it at the same time. So there is no point comparing yourself to, you know, that mum friend who's a teacher and who's got it all sorted, or that other mum friend who's got a routine and goes out every day and does this every day. There is no point in comparing yourself to what other parents are doing, because we're all doing the best we can and we all cope differently. Don't put yourself through the stress of doing what looks right. Instead, do what feels right. And what feels right to everyone is completely different. So that's it. I hope these thoughts were helpful to you to hopefully turn homeschooling into a positive experience, whatever it is that you choose to do. If you're on a schedule, if you're not, if you've got a routine, if you're just winging it, if you're not homeschooling at all and just having fun, I hope you found these helpful. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit that little notification bell so you get a little ping on your phone when there's a new video from me. And hopefully I'll see you very soon. Bye.